In the last video, we created a table structure for our small database, and we designed the relationships of the different tables. And now we want to start to create some forms. And we will create one form for the graves. And later on, we will add some elements and subforms for that. We will start immediately with one subform. Let me show you this. Okay, we start using the assistant here, and when this pops up, you have to select for which table we want to create a form. So we use the graves, and we want to have all the fields there. So we can select individual fields by selecting the field and clicking here, or if we want all, we can just click this button here, and then all fields are present here, fields in the form. Now they are all there. Okay, next, and now we have to add. We want to add a subform, and we want to add a subform based on an existing relation. We defined that before, and let's start with the subform for artifacts. Okay, we use this, click next, and then we are again asked which fields should be included in this time the subform, and also here we want to have all the fields. Except for the grave ID, we don't need that because this will be set automatically, but to show you this, I will include them now and delete this field later on. Okay, next. And now we can specify how the form should look like. So there are two possible selections here, one for the main form and one for the subform. For the main form, I would like to have them this, so the description is on top and down below is the other data fields that where we can enter data. And the subform I actually like, I could also use a different setup here, but I like to have this in tabular form so that we can see on one glance all the objects here, all the artifacts that are related to this to this burial, to this grave here. So I stick with the tabular form here. Then I can define the data entry mode. So should this only be used for new data, or should existing data also be displayed? No, I want to have all data, and I don't want to restrict the modification, deletion, or addition of new data. I want to have this all like it is, so you can do everything with this form. So just having marked this is fine. And next we can change a bit the style. So if we don't like this beige here, I opt for a funny, happy, light gray. And I don't like this 3D look, so I go to flat. You can see how this changes here in the back. Next, I have to define a name for the form. Graves is fine here. And on the next thing, what I want to do next, work with the form or modify the form. Currently we just select work with the form. Finish. And since I have two monitors, this opens on the other monitor. So now we have here already some fields available. We can have here our, I already entered some data, so that's why here something is already present, and I can see here down below the data for this burial, for this grave. So I remove first some stuff. So now we start with ID 1. I also said that should have grave number 1. Let's have that 2.5 meters deep, 3.5 meters deep, 2.5 meters in length, and 1.3 meters in width, and I don't add here anything to the construction. You can see here, down below here are the artifacts, and we can already enter some information here. So I say that should be a needle, and when I enter something here, we can see that there is a new data record popping up. And when I click to this one, you can see that the grave ID is automatically filled because we're working on grave 0 here, and so the grave ID here is also 0. Yeah, that's it. So with that, we have already a form and a working subform for the artifacts. But two things are not very nice here. On the one hand, we have only this one subform, and we also want to have subforms for the individuals and the C14 dates present within this form. We have to add them. And also site ID. It is a bit annoying that we always have to type site ID here, while we have the sites already entered, and probably a drop down would be nicer. And the same holds true here in the subform. So let's first change this in the next video, and then we will also add more subforms in the later videos.